Young, founder of the beauty body.com, is spicing things up this morning for Black History Month.
Oh, yeah. She is showcasing healthy dishes featuring three of her favorite food finds, all produced by Black-owned companies. Good morning, Nicole. Good to see you.
Good morning, you guys. How are you? Good.
Doing
are
you? Great. Okay, so this morning you're sharing three of your favorite items. They're not only healthy, but they are produced by Black-owned companies. So give us an idea what these are.
So these are three of my favorite brands. There are plenty of great Black-owned food brands on the market, but what I love about these is that these three in particular are healthy, they're sustainably created, so they're good for you, they're good for the environment, and I find them to be quite tasty and delicious, and you can use them in a lot of different ways.
Okay.
So let's talk about some of the ingredients, right? What do you got?
Let's start. Okay, so the first dish that you guys are trying, I think Betty, you're trying it, is a surf and earth grain bowl.
The shrimp, right?
This is made, yes, that's the shrimp bowl. So this dish is made with a product called Yolele Fonio. Now, Fonio is a West African super grain. See. It is so good for you. It's really, really healthy.
It's it tastes like protein. Quinoa.
It's similar to quinoa. It's way healthier for you, though, because, for example, a cup of cooked quinoa is about 220 calories.
Is it really?
Whereas Fonio is under, let's see, it's 140 calories, actually, for a cup of
You almost cut
Fonio.
That calorie count in half.
In half. It's much higher in fiber, protein, amino acids, and it has that light, nutty flavor. Mm-hmm. It absorbs a lot of different types of seasonings and spice blends. You could use it in the same way that you would use quinoa or really any grain.
I like that you put mushroom with
grain bowl.
I had no idea that quinoa had so many calories. Mm-hmm. I thought it was healthy.
It and does, carbs,
it
does. Right?
It is healthy, but they're both carbohydrates, but these are the healthier carbs, even quinoa. But calorie-wise, you are going to do better with
the
Fonio.
So your next item has a little bit of some kick to it. I like kick.
Yes. So the next item is a spicy zucchini and fennel bisque. Mm. Now, this soup is a combination of fennel, zucchini, shallots. It's just all blended. I roast the vegetables first, then I blend them in the blender, puree them nice and smooth, add a little low sodium vegetable stock, but then I spice it up with these yellow habanero peppers. That is from a company called Aya Foods, another Black-owned food brand. And
how's
the
it?
Peppers are made from 100% Cameroonian
spicy?
Pepper.
Ooh, you just ripped it all over the computer.
Is it that spicy?
Is it really?
I like the little kick.
Okay.
You like the kick, right? It's not too much. Habaneros can be
apparently I don't know how to
spicy,
eat soup.
Of course.
I just learned. I don't know how to eat soup.
Here.
Pick up the spoon. Get that babe over there. This is crazy. I included one in the package. I just didn't bring it out for you.
So you just puree all this together.
I roasted the vegetables first, pureed it, seasoned it with the yellow habanero powder, which is made from just 100% habaneros, nothing artificial in there, no preservatives,
I like
no additives.
This a lot.
So you're getting natural spice, lots of kick, healthy soup.
I really like this a lot. This is great.
I'm glad you like it.
Okay, so we
Does
have.
Does it taste healthy?
He can't stop
healthy.
Eating it.
I love healthy.
I love that.
Okay, so tell us about this third item.
So my third item is a sauteed fruit salad. Now, this is one of the things that I love to whip up. It's super easy. I chunked apples and then I sliced pears. I like the Bartlett pears. You can choose any apple you like, but the Bartletts are firm. You slice them up, you saute them in a little bit of coconut oil, but then to add something special, I add about less than an eighth of a teaspoon of this mango chili medley from Essie Spice.
Okay.
It's another Black-owned. This is a female Black-owned company. And the spice, the sauces and the spice blends that they make, super natural, no preservatives. Again, what they use to preserve these sauces is rice vinegar. So it also cuts down on the acidity, which is great for your digestion. This mango medley has antioxidants in there. There's onions, which are great for gut health. Mm-hmm. So you're getting healthy, spicy, flavorful stuff without anything unnatural. And of course, you're supporting Black-owned businesses.
Absolutely. Now, because that is all natural there, do you have to keep it refrigerated?
Once you open it, it is sold on the shelves. It's shelf stable, but once you open it, you do have to refrigerate it. And the sooner you use it, the better, of course.
Okay, Nicole, recipes aside, I hear you're in the running for a pretty cool title.
Mm-hmm.
What is this
I
all about? You're in a contest for what?
I'm in a contest for Favorite Chef, the title of Favorite Chef. So if you follow me on Instagram at Nicole Young Style, you'll see a link in my bio to vote for me in the contest. Right now, I'm currently in the top 20. Mm. I'm trying to make it into the top 15.
Okay. Yes.
The voting closes tomorrow, so I could really, really use your votes. And the proceeds from this contest are going towards Feeding America, so it's
a great
cause as well.
Well, Nicole, you are our favorite chef always. We don't have to put you in any kind of poll for that.
Is there garlic in this bisque?
There is no garlic in that bisque.
Oh, good.
Because I personally am not a big fan of garlic, so I cook with it as little to zero as possible.
Oh, good, Nicole. I'm with you. Okay.
Thanks so much. This is great stuff.
Mine is my Sunday gravy. You got to put garlic in the Sunday gravy.
I do love me
some garlic. Fair. That's fair.
Or sauce.
But you don't need it in the zucchini soup.
All right. Nicole, thank you. Good luck on the contest.
Thank you, guys. Cast your votes.
Oh, I will.